Do you exercise your right to get some exercise? I hope you do. I did a push-up today. Actually, I fell down, but I had to push myself back up, so technically that counts, right? Much of the exercise I engage in is unintentional these days. For instance, hopping around the living room after stepping on Lego pieces is unexpected and painful, and a far more rigorous activity than I had planned. Picking an ice cube off the floor sounds easy. It's not. I got a 6-minute cardio workout chasing one around with my fingers trying to pick the thing up. Finally, it melted. I was steamed at first, but it was just water under the fridge. Seriously, I walk about 8 kilometers a day, I really do, and I jog when I badly need to, like when the ice cream truck is speeding past. Well, Prince Philip would not have been impressed. When he passed away 2 months short of his 100th birthday, those watching his funeral learned that the prince followed the 5BX physical fitness plan. Look it up, go for it. It requires 11 minutes a day of rigorous stretching, sit-ups, push-ups, extending your back, and running in place. Afterwards, you follow it up with diddly squats. Okay, I am most excellent at diddly squats, just so you know. That part I made up. The diddly squats isn't true, the rest is. I often heard my mother humming God Save the Queen. She never pretended the royals were perfect, but she prayed for them, and she looked for praiseworthy stuff to report. I think we can all learn from Prince Philip's life. His blunders delighted many, particularly the media, but I wonder how any of us would fare if our every sentence was recorded and the tabloids hounded us. We're wise to watch our words, of course, and usually the prince did. Once, while sitting beside a woman at a university dinner, he asked why she was here. She said, "I'm the wife of the college rector." Philip said, "I believe that's the least interesting thing about you." They went on to have a splendid conversation. And what an approach. What a way to enhance relationships. Surely this is the great friendship secret, taking an active interest in others, listening. He often downplayed his own story. "It's a big mistake to think about yourself," he said. "What counts is what you do for others." Recent portrayals cast the prince in a very negative light, but his most credible biographers challenge such reports. Those close to him and the Queen, Queen Elizabeth, labeled their 73-year marriage rock solid. Biographer Giles Brandreth writes of seeing the Queen surrounded by dignitaries in a crowded room. Standing far off by the huge windows was Prince Philip. When Her Majesty caught his eye, Philip raised his glass to her and smiled. From Kurt Hahn, a German Jew who escaped Nazi Germany, Philip learned that the best way to overcome unwelcome change comes in service to others. He rose above a childhood scarred by turbulence and family tragedies and served in the Royal Navy for nearly 14 years, 6 of them during wartime. Devotion to duty and service, he insisted, outweighed fear, something that should inspire all of us in a world of increasing uncertainty and change. The language of his faith may be different from ours, but I appreciate the author and columnist John Musgrove's take. Key to his success is the Christian idea of the servant king working to release the creative good. The couple attended Crathy Kirk Balmoral, where the Reverend Ian Bradley often preached. The Duke took notes so the two of them could discuss doctrine over lunch later on. His library contained 11,000 books, many on theology. And according to Bradley, the prince encouraged the Queen to speak more openly of her Christian faith during her Christmas broadcasts. Prince Philip told John Sentamu of the Yorkshire Post, "The Queen and I are so strong in Jesus Christ." After Prince Philip's death, Paul Williams, chief executive of the Bible Society, gave thanks to God for his contribution to the life of the nation, and most of all, for his long and loving partnership with the Queen. May we all be challenged to practice friendship, fidelity, and faith, and get some exercise too. I, for one, am about to walk through a Lego minefield on my way to look for more ice cubes. You want to help make stories of hope and joy available around the world? Make sure to hit that subscribe button and like this video today. Thanks.